outside my door, stretched out and purring, waiting for more. String sheet of stung, deep cat I grieve. No way to escape, no one hears my scream. He's come here so often, just when I'm alone. I can't help the longing, I'll feel when he moans.
Everyone tonight. This is Kerry Cassidy from Charge of Camelot, Whistleblower Radio, and we are going to have, a very unusual and dynamic show this evening. We're going to have two guests, my scheduled guest, who is Maxine Taylor, and she's an astrologer and an author of, I believe, two books at this point, and she's going to tell you more about that. But I'm also going to have David Wilcock on the air with me here, who has just received a death threat, and we are going to ask our audience to focus, surround him with white light and protection. We've gotten in touch with some very important people here, and hold on one second.
I'm here.
Bye. Okay, hi, David. You're there.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so let me repeat this. David Wilcock has received a death threat. I've asked him to come on my show at the last minute here after I just got a notice myself about it. We have contacted the necessary people to protect him, and they are going to be doing that. But I also am asking the listening audience to surround him with white light and protection. And if you have any means to address this situation from a multiple of angles, please do so. And so go ahead, David, and tell your story and let's deal with this.
All right.
It's okay. Let's just take it one step at a time. Yeah, and I just want to say that you are beloved by many, many people out there, and I have contacted a very important person who can definitely help you in every way. Do not worry. Whatever can be done will be done on your behalf. And I have to say, I've seen the future, and you're going to be fine.
Well, I appreciate that. So I've been covering this Fulford story, and I released information about something that is much more secret than UFOs. And I was called today after I put this online, and this particular individual was called by two different people. And one of them said, "Do you like David Wilcock?" That was how he started the conversation. And, he said that both of these people basically said the same thing, which is that I need to get part two of the article out tonight. They wouldn't go into detail, but I was told that that if I was tortured, that would be lucky, and that probably I wouldn't make it, but that if I get through the next 3 days, it'll probably be okay. But that I would be much safer if I could get this information out tonight, because I was led to believe that if someone is going to come and talk to me and give me the gun or the money game where they try to buy me out or threaten me with death and maybe narco-hypnosis or something like that, mind control kind of things, I don't know. But that basically all I have before that team could show up here is tonight. So I felt like, I'm sorry for crying.
No, David, you know, we're with you, and really, it's okay. You know, you are surrounded by incredible light, as you know, okay? And you are so loved. I just can't even say the number of people out there. The word is getting out. Believe me, this situation will be handled from so many different directions. I just want you to hang in there and stay with us and talk to us about not only this, but what the story is that you're being told to keep to get out there. You've got this forum right here. We've got radio stations. I'm sure that we're going to get some simulcasts out there hooked up. Anyone who knows anyone who's a broadcaster in radio, please ask them to take this break. David, you are totally going to be okay. What matters here is that you keep it together and that you are able to tell us the story. Because this is going to protect you. The truth, putting it out there, this is what's going to protect you. Okay? Once it's out there, they can't touch you. It's in the public domain. So let's get it out there.
All right. I'll pull it together. Fulford has never... Okay. I guess, okay, the context. This is what I now know. I have been in contact. I've been in touch with Benjamin Fulford. He came out on the scene in 2007, as we all know. And what he ultimately has been saying is that there's an alliance of 117 nations, and those nations are aligned against the Illuminati, which, if you don't know, is the secret political leadership of the G5 countries, and not a whole lot else anymore. They were running a lot of other countries by proxy. They were having puppet dictators running a lot of these countries in the Middle East and in Africa. And those countries are now claiming back their sovereignty. And the tip of the spear of what they have been planning to blow this whole thing open is a lawsuit. Fulford has been talking about this lawsuit on his website for at least a year and a half. The website was published. It was filed. Fulford said it would be filed on November 15th. It was filed on November 23rd. It's 111 pages long. It's incredibly intricate. I downloaded it when it first showed up. I thought it was bullshit when it first showed up because they quoted from Wikipedia regarding the Davos World Economic Forum. I wrote a long missive on Benjamin Fulford's website saying that I thought this thing was bullshit. After that, the people who were responsible for filing the lawsuit contacted me personally. We began a relationship, which has led to an extensive amount of contact. They have sent me over 500 photographs. They have sent me dozens of documents. These documents apparently have put a bounty on my head. I now have seen the Book of Maklumat, the Book of Codes. I have seen the exact documentation that will bring these people down. It's in my possession. I am soon going to be getting it, very soon going to be getting it to other people who already have the Wilcock file. You people know who you are. Please do not inspect the file. Only go with Category 1 distribution if something happens to me. If you look in the revealing folder, I have a list of criteria. Do not release Category 2 unless the criteria of the revealing folder are met. At least 3 of the points in that folder must be met before you release Category 2. But category one would only occur if I am killed. Okay, if you don't hear from me in 3 or 4 days, then go ahead and put it out there. In addition to that, if I put out a code phrase, as you guys know, because it's in the revealing folder, and that code phrase says that if you see that in my next update, then you have to go with distribution plan one. And that's all in the folder. Okay, so this is what we need to do. This is the plan that I put in place. I never expected I would need to use this. Kerry, you know I told you I recorded everything. It's a betrayal, but I recorded everything that happened when I was on the phone with Henry Deacon. I told him this when he was out here. That's part of what's in that file. There's a lot of other very juicy things in that file. Don't make me do this, please, okay? Okay, I gotta calm down. So, these people, here's the story. Adam Smith, The Wealth of Nations, 1700s, wrote this document in which he said that if countries hold gold, that they are a risk to the world. This is the basis of what everything else that follows in the story comes from. Adam Smith, The Wealth of Nations. The argument was that the people who hold the gold could take it out of one country and move it to another, but therefore a country's national sovereignty is at risk if they have gold. Any one country that is on the gold standard or any precious metal standard is a risk to the rest of the world. They become a detriment to the world. The argument was that the gold has to be kept off of the market, kept out of the international market. This is the biggest secret. The gold had to be confiscated so that originally the idea was that wealth would be created in proportion to the amount of wealth that the people of that nation are creating. In other words, the country issues fiat currency against the wealth created by their nation. The problem was if you have a gold standard and you have people being born and they make more things and they create more wealth, there's no more extra gold, and so the price of money goes up, which means if people have money, it becomes worth less and less and less, and it destroys the country. So ultimately, you have to eliminate the gold standard in order to prevent against inflation, like you saw in Weimar Republic Germany, where people have money in a wheelbarrow to buy a loaf of bread. And this plan moved forward with the British Empire, secretly run by the Rothschilds, working as a proxy, where they knew that 85% of the world's gold was contained in Asia. The reason why it was in Asia was that the people of the world, including the Roman Empire and the Spaniards much later, were taking all the gold in the world, and they were using that gold to pay for things that were coming from China, Asia, Indonesia, including things like spices that were very exotic and unavailable anywhere else, ceramics such as fine silks with beautiful patterns and colors, very fine china and pottery, these elaborate vases that had gold leaf painting on them of dragons and things like this. People wanted this stuff. It was way better quality than anything else in the world, and they paid for it in gold. And somehow, because China had really good stuff, they ended up with most of the world's gold. Is this all clear so far, Kerry?
Well, it is as a historical, you know, sort of history. But at this moment, I think the people are going to be confused as to why this has centered on you.
Okay. It turns out that the Rothschild / British Empire invaded Japan and used Japan to go after China. There was Emperor Hirohito in 1921, went to London, and they created the Bank of International Settlements. A secret treaty was made at this time. Fulford has been given this information. He's not apparently used about 90% of the information that these people have been giving him. I don't know why, but it was given to me, and I'm trying to give it to you as fast as I can right now. In 1921, the Bank of International Settlements was created. They created a plan, a very secret plan, in which all the gold in the world would be confiscated and put under deposit secretly. That did occur. It occurred through Hirohito and his Japanese army in a plan called Golden Lily, where they invaded China and they plundered the gold out of China. First, they came in with bandits. The bandits robbed them of the gold, killed people. Then the Japanese army comes in and says, oh, you got a bandit problem, we'll save you. when in fact it's two sides of the same coin. The gold was stored in various locations. Now, here's the important part. There are 2 million tons of gold on deposit held by the Bank of International Settlements and the Federal Reserve. Secretly, the countries of the world have this money on deposit. The amount of money in actual terms of the spot value of gold, based on my calculation of the spot price of gold as of 4 days ago, the amount of money that they actually have is $11 million trillion. Everything you think you've been told about how gold is scarce is not true. This is the biggest secret. This is what people are shitting their pants, and they do not want me to talk about this because nobody expected this was going to make it out into the open. And that's what's happening right now. That's the secret. That's the story. The story is that through the threat that led up to World War II, much of the gold in the world was plundered. It was plundered in the U.S. because they made it illegal to own gold. If you had gold, they took it out of your safe deposit box. The Jews were robbed of their gold. They had much of the gold in Europe. This is... So we'll talk more about that after the break, I guess.
Having a very unusual show at this point. I've got Maxine Taylor, I believe, who's going to be on the line with us, and she is an astrologer as well as, I will say, an intuitive, and so I don't think it's a bad thing that she's actually here, although we're not going to be able to talk about what we were planning on talking about. We've got David Wilcock, who has received a death threat, and it's very serious. From what I understand, David, are you still with me?
Yes.
You've got on divinecosmos.com, you have written the part one of a communique to the people about a situation with regard to a lawsuit and gold. And he's been explaining the situation because of what he wrote, from what I understand, and because of some association with Benjamin Fulford. He has received a very serious death threat. We are in the process of bringing on somebody else on this show who is going to address the situation from, let us say, a more strategic viewpoint, and that person will be known as anonymous when they come on the air. Okay, David, would you continue to describe the situation?
Okay. The last 3 weeks have been amazing. These people have welcomed me into their trust. In 1938, there was gold, 7 giant U.S. battleships worth of gold that was held by the Asians, that was shipped to the U.S., that was put on deposit secretly with the Federal Reserve, and bonds were issued in exchange for this money. There was supposed to be a plan in Bretton Woods that the Bretton Woods Agreement of 1944 is when, after World War II, all of this gold confiscation was complete. One insider told me that he toured a facility personally in which you walk down a hall. It's a mile long. There are doors on either side of the hall. Each of those doors leads into a room the size of a basketball gymnasium in which there are gold bullion bars in bricks stacked floor to ceiling. I was told by another insider that gold is actually more plentiful than sand. I mean, they're kind of kidding, but the point is that if you go on Wikipedia, it will say there's 120,000 tons of gold that's officially recognized in the world. The actual number apparently is over 2 million tons. If you calculate what 2 million tons is worth on current spot price, it's $11 million trillion. This is the currency, this is the actual collateral that secretly backs up all of the currencies of the world. It is only an illusion that it's all fiat bubble money backed by nothing. The countries of the world needed that collateral to know that they could trust the economic systems. There is gold in Fort Knox, there is gold in other treasuries, but they are apologetically low compared to the amount that's really there. It's only a smoke and mirror show for the public. But apparently this plan has allowed them, what they ended up doing is they confiscated all the world's wealth so that nobody could ever rise up against the fiat bubble money system in which they just type numbers into a computer and those numbers appear as money. So that's what we're dealing with. This is how it was done. It's apparently the biggest secret there is, and they don't want you to talk about this, but it appears that, you know, there's the gold is kept in underground facilities. It's kept, there's sunken ships at the bottom of the Mariana Trench and elsewhere throughout Southeast Asia where this gold is being kept. There is a treasure room on the island of Taiwan underneath the island that was hand-dug by laborers. It is 40 miles by 50 miles wide and 7 terraces deep. Apparently half of this entire room is filled with gold on one side and the precious treasures of China on the other side. Ever since the 1920s up until the late 30s, China had every ship that they had sending this gold and treasure out to Taiwan constantly. There is a very extreme amount of secrecy around all this. It is not public domain. UFOs, by comparison, is very easy to get information about. I have been researching these subjects ever since 1996 on the internet. I've had access to insiders since 2001 when I went to Dr. Stephen Greer's Disclosure Project of Washington, D.C. on May 10th, a closed executive summary briefing for members of Congress. I have never heard about this before, but I since found documentation that you can read. There's a website, it's called deepblacklies.co.uk. It is written by a man named David Guyatt, G-U-Y-A-T-T. If you go to his website, it's a little bit complicated and you need to have a PC, but you can actually download for free 5 different books that he wrote. Those books include absolutely compelling documents from the Committee of 300, from the Trilateral Commission, from UBS Bank in Switzerland. They show you the codes. They show you the documentation. It's an open secret. I didn't know this was out there. It's like you have to know what questions to ask before you can open the doors. And then once I knew what questions to ask, I spoke to certain insiders, and those insiders gave me more information. And I went forward and published an article that reveals this lawsuit that Fulford and the people that contacted Fulford are filing. In the lawsuit, the list of defendants includes the United Nations, the Italian Prime Minister, the head of the World Economic Forum. These are very heavy hitters. The lawsuit is for $1 trillion. And this lawsuit is the tip of the spear that drives a wedge that will actually lead to the defeat of what I lovingly call the old world order. And it all comes back to China shipping off 7 battleships worth of gold to the U.S. The Federal Reserve gave them bonds as collateral for that. The money was then put on deposit and used to underwrite the world economic system beginning in 1944 with Bretton Woods. They were promised, as a result of doing this, the Asians were promised that the money would be used for the betterment of the world, for the development of Asia and Africa. And by 1954, they realized that was not happening. They rebelled. They wanted to have change. That change eventually led to a plan that involved John Fitzgerald Kennedy and President Suharto of Indonesia. Kennedy actually issued an executive order, which is 11110, in which he was going to be able to issue silver-backed currency under his own decree, short-circuiting the Federal Reserve, and that would have created a precious metal-based currency. He was assassinated 3 days after he did this. The Asians did not have the military might to be able to mount any other effective opposition. They literally waited for about 30 years until the charter that started in 1944 for Bretton Woods expired in 1994. They sued for the changing of the Federal Reserve System and for the whole system of world economics. The people that run the Federal Reserve said no. This then led to another suit that came out in 1998, where China attempted to reclaim the gold that was now, they call it, stolen from them in 1938. It was a 60-year term that expired. The lawsuit was lost. In other words, the Federal Reserve lost the lawsuit in the secret trial that was at The Hague in the United Nations. And as a result of them losing this lawsuit, they had a settlement put on them, and they were told that they had to return the money on September 12, 2001. Money was being held under Building 7 in the World Trade Center, and obviously the day before September 12th, look at what happened. We now know, we've heard that there was a gold vault under the Building 7, that it was emptied, but now with the context of Fulford and what these people are telling me, that's why that happened. Okay, nothing else happened until there was another lawsuit placed against the Federal Reserve. They did come through, they did send out gold, except that when the gold was taken in by the Chinese, it turned out that it was tungsten that was electroplated with gold on the outside. It was worthless. Since that time, the Chinese changed their strategy. This isn't really the ruling party of China. It's not the communists. It's the deposed party under Chiang Kai-shek called the Kuomintang that fled to Taiwan and Indonesia and the Philippines and elsewhere. So we need to make that clear. But anyway, to get to the story, because I'm trying to do this as fast as I can, the Federal Reserve lost. They handed this gold off to the Kuomintang. The gold was fake. The Kuomintang responded by organizing an international alliance that caused the collapsing of the dollar and many American corporations. That was the 2008 financial collapse. In the aftermath of the 2008 financial collapse, they created this TARP shit where they bailed everybody out. Nobody expected they were going to do that. It totally caught them by surprise that they created that much money out of thin air. It delayed the plans. The next part of the plans involved this China's October surprise thing. Go to my website, divinecosmos.com. You can read all about that. But now what's happened is that there's also this plan involving this lawsuit. There's 117 nations behind it. In fact, the number's now gone up to 122. From what I'm hearing, and you know, whatever they do to me, it's not going to change this. So you guys are barking up the wrong tree here. If you're threatening me, you're only making it worse for yourselves.
Okay, you're David. Yeah. This person and several of the people that are interested in protecting you need to know exactly how the threats came to you.
They probably know who the insider is. This insider called me by phone earlier today this person told me that he had been called by two different people. Both of these people said that I would be very wise to release part two tonight, that it would be much safer for me if I released it tonight, that tomorrow might be too late. I was told that if I were tortured, that I would be lucky.
Okay, but if you release it, are you not going to be tortured? Is the idea that if you release
it... Yeah, I was told that I'd be a lot safer if I got it out tonight.
And are you planning to be on this radio show? Are you planning to get it out tonight?
Yeah, I mean, I'm giving you the core of it. And then the only other thing that's left that I haven't already said is question and answers with the people that are on this lawsuit. But I've basically, as fast as possible, I've summarized the whole thing for you. That's
okay,
really all there is left.
Does the white hat information dovetail with this?
Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of corollaries here. There's a lot of people that are all kind of saying the same thing. I mean, this is what's terrifying to people who are in leadership positions in the G5 countries, because they don't like where this is going. They don't like the fact that, you know, the people are going to be very pissed off when they find out that economics has been completely hijacked, that none of this economic collapse stuff ever needed to happen, and that all of the world's wealth was confiscated to be able to allow them to, what should have been actually a positive thing, and could be a positive thing if it was measured correctly, which is just to issue money based on the amount of wealth that the nations are generating. But what it turned into is this ridiculous black screen thing where they just type numbers in a computer. The only way they could do that, the only way they could take control of the planet and create as much money as they want out of thin air, is by confiscating all the actual gold that really existed. That is the biggest secret. That's the secret that has taken me all this time to learn.
Well, okay,
and I might have given my life to learn.
My understanding is there's no way that they have it all if some of it is under basically underwater in the Philippines, for one thing.
Well, it's all registered. That's the thing you got to understand. This money is all, it's all documented.
Okay, but the white hats are, you know, have been involved in this, which is, you know, their Blogspot. I forget. It's something like Dark Cabal Blogspot or something .com.
Right.
But at any rate, if you want to read more about this from that perspective. Okay, we're going to a break. We've got a person that's coming on the line shortly here. David, would I know this witness?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. And we are live with David Wilcock in a very serious situation in which he has received several death threats today as a result of an article he wrote. Part one is now on the web at divinecause.com, and he will be releasing part two tonight, but we are also doing this over the air now. To take some of the heat off him, we are going to bring on a person who is working in a sensitive capacity around the world. He's been notified of the situation. He has the ability to get the right people involved to make sure that David is protected. Let's put it that way. David, what you're going to need to do is go over the situation for our caller. Caller, are you on the air here? We've got Anonymous. Are you live?
Hey, you're talking to me.
Hi there. Thank you so much for coming on the call. I do understand that you work in a very sensitive capacity, that you were just notified of the situation with David Wilcock, that you are concerned, and we welcome your presence here on the air with us tonight. David will be happy to answer all of your questions and will go over everything for you. David, say hello to Anonymous.
Hi there.
Hi there, David. I understand you've got a few problems there.
Yeah, it hasn't been a very good day.
Well, can you tell me at all what's been happening to you, lad?
I have been following this Benjamin Fulford story for a long time. He has been talking for 2 years now about a lawsuit that was going to be filed. It goes back to the Chinese, the Kuomintang, who had gold that they sent to the Federal Reserve in 1938 on 7 battleships. The bonds were issued against that gold. It's all being kept secret. It's part of a vast trove of gold that is held as collateral against the world's economy. Fiat, bubble money, very, very few people know this. You probably do, but most people don't. The Kuomintang are trying to get that gold repatriated, or at least get a fairer representation. Apparently it has caused a great deal of turmoil that they are doing this. And this lawsuit, I think, even though it was filed, it's official, it's on record with pacer.gov, and it was covered by Courthouse News Service, apparently these people who threatened me were very, very angry that I put all this story together about the lawsuit to try to reclaim this lost Chinese gold. They threatened Benjamin Fulford, apparently. He disappeared for a day and a half. There was a television show he was supposed to be on. The people on the show said live on the air that he had been detained by a CIA-type group and held against his will in a hotel. Then Fulford shows up a day and a half later, calls the guy on the lawsuit who I'm now in contact with, and said, oh, no, I'm fine. I just went off to the mountains and had fun with my wife, and then I came home and I went to sleep. Whereas Chogyam Daikaku, this guy who is apparently the head of the martial arts societies of karate and aikido in Japan, goes on the television show the next day and says that, in fact, he negotiated for Fulford's release, that it was very nasty. And so I posted all this on my wedding to document it. The very next morning, I get this phone call saying that if I wanted to put out part two of my article, I'd better do it tonight, because there may not be a tomorrow for me. That's the situation I'm under right now.
Well, you better put out part two then.
As soon as the show gets done, I'm going online. That's what I'm doing.
That's not disappointing me. Make sure you don't leave anything out then.
Okay.
And we'll see. There was a lady who rang you. Was he kind enough to leave you a phone number so you could talk to him?
Yeah, I mean, the insider who called me, I can call him whenever I want. He was called by two other people, one of whom said, do you like David Wilcock? And then, you know, well, you might want to talk to him while you have a chance.
Well, David, we like you. And we'd be really unhappy if anything was to be happening to you.
I appreciate that.
I hope we can make that clear to all of yours. And all the folks out there that are listening in all the communities that we all know about.
Would it be helpful if David were to type into the Skype here a phone number where you could reach this this contact?
Well, it'd save me looking up in the phone book, Lassie.
Right. So, David, if you're able to type into that information, I think that would be very helpful.
Okay.
I have a theory on who this is, and I believe that person may be standing by. If they're not standing by, if there's a way for you to make that possible, or if somebody else who's with you can do that, that'd be great.
Well, this person would not come on the air, but I'm sending
I
you...
I totally understand that.
Sort of. Okay. I've interrupted my humanitarian work here, and I don't think there'd be anything happening. So don't worry too much.
Well, I appreciate that, and I know that if you get grumpy, then some people will be very upset.
I'd hate to be grumpy. It's Christmas time, you know, there.
Okay,
I'm...
Don't
be grumpy.
So this is just for the people that are on this. This is a private phone number. It is not to go out onto the air.
Yeah, and please.
The person is not to be called under any circumstances, other than by our very illustrious guest who is on a secret job site out in the larger world.
Yeah, please call. Please make that connection. And
let me make it clear to you, for all your viewers, you don't know this, David. The gold you're talking about is a small amount of gold. It's not a lot of gold when you consider the amounts of gold we're dealing with. We deal with vast amounts far in excess of what you think you know about. The gold is so wide and so vast that the real problem is how to keep it all down and keep it quiet. It doesn't matter. The long foul days of all of that gunboat diplomacy is long gone. And the low-level fellows that try to think that they're somehow dining things have nothing to do with it. And if any of these little lads who hang on with their public service jobs want to create a little problem, oh, look, let's create a big fucking problem. Oh, well, sorry for the language. I've been out here in the field too long. But we know where they all live too. We know where all their families are. We know where everybody is.
That's very important. I think it bears repeating. So, caller, because your voice is a little faint, David.
Well, I'm a long way away, Bessie. If you only knew how far away I was.
Okay.
Let me tell you that I'm so far away you couldn't believe.
Right. but David, could you repeat that for the public? I'm going to let you repeat that they know where these people are. They know their homes, their houses, their families, they know all the details.
I can hear the caller very well. I hope that the audience can too. If not, we can probably post-produce this after the live show and bring the levels up so everybody will be able to hear this. It is true that I have spoken to people all across the spectrum at the very highest levels of every part of this cover-up. What this caller has notified us about is that there is much more gold, even than what I was referring to on the show just now. The problem is how to keep it from really damaging human life on it. People know this. It could really cause a lot of pain for a while. I do think there needs to be a change. I do think this lawsuit needs to be made public. But I'm not sure that, you know, I'm not an expert. I'm not an economist. I just wanted to write about a story. I'm not the president. I'm not running the country. All I'm doing is writing about this, and you know,
let me say that caller, and this is for the anonymous caller here to address. But isn't it true that a lot of the gold is being taken off world as the anyway?
Well, it gets put everywhere, you know, it's all over the. Okay. You ask it now, would you?
Okay, we're sorry, but we actually have to go to break. We don't have a choice on this. We will be right back with this developing story with David Wilcock, our anonymous caller, and Maxine Taylor, who's standing by. Thank you very much. Project Camelot Whistleblower Radio. We have a very sort of developing story at the moment with regard to David Wilcock, who has received death threats for an article that he wrote on divinecosmos.com. And I urge everyone to go to that website. We are in the process. My webmaster, Tommy Hansen, is in Norway, and it's the middle of the night there, but he has come online, and he is working on trying to get a PDF so that this is downloadable. We have gotten word from our listeners that they want to be able to download the article and distribute it around the net. We've got Anonymous on the line standing by. Anonymous, are you there?
I am still here.
Okay, Anonymous, we are really grateful to have you with us. We would like to talk about this developing story. I do want to ask you a question, because it's my understanding that in some ways these kind of death threats, which I have also received in the past, are a type of psychological operation more than anything else. Do you think this is a psyop?
I think they're just troublemakers.
You think they're troublemakers?
We don't like it. It ruins the industry reputation.
It ruins the... I was going to, you know, pretty. That's a pretty tall order to ruin the reputation of the Illuminati, but I guess they're going to work on it. Can you elaborate, Colin?
Yeah, look, we've got a simple rule. If you fellas are, just tell the truth. Don't embellish. Tell the truth and don't compromise anyone's privacy, their addresses, their families. You're as safe as if you're in a bank, vault full of gold.
So David hasn't told the addresses or any of that stuff.
No, I mean, part two, what's going to be released tonight, which I've already had the guys reviewing the document and making sure that they have no objections. They actually wrote me. I mean, I have an email here, and I'm going to read it. Let's see if I can find it. He said, "Dear David, my only suggestions are to remove the names of blank, blank, and remove the part where you mention names of people who have been talking to blank."
These well, people I think have I said that, didn't I?
Yes, this is what he's saying. He says, these people have to live with the very people who are the ones we are fighting, and I think it is a breach of confidence to leak their names. More than that, a number which now includes name, name, and name are now feeding us information from directly inside the highest levels of the Cabal. We should not expose them, as it would negate their usefulness to us. Like us, they want change, but they have to work with those whom we are fighting. The only other thing I request...
David, my boy. That's all fine. I'm not a good numbers man with all of this sort of thing. But let me tell you this. I know that all your ears, all your listeners can know. There's many more tens of millions of tons of fine precious metals around the place than you could ever imagine. What you're talking about is a sand bucket full of nonsense. It doesn't matter. It's little. It's unimportant. And all those little fiddles that are so far down the ladder, they're all buzzing around like ants trying to fight the red breadcrumbs that fall off the table.
Okay, so what the caller is saying, if I understand, caller, and you can correct me if I'm wrong, you're basically saying that the threats are coming from a lower level. Isn't that right?
They're a bunch of fools as far as I'm concerned.
Okay, so it is important to know that we're talking about different levels. And by the way, a PDF has now been created of your article by Tommy Hansen.
It's
going to be mounted on our forum, where people can go to CamelotForum.com. I assume that that Tommy, who is listening, will start a thread for this radio show and for this situation, where people can post and all kinds of things can be said and whatever. But we will allow David to monitor that thread as well, and put the PDF there so that people can have access to downloading it as they need to. But basically, to get back to the caller, what you're saying is that the gold is plentiful, that the people who are actually making threats regarding certain gold are kind of off base, in a sense.
Pretty much so. These little offshoots and these little cells that grow independently, they're all concerning at times. But if they become too noticeable for us, we'll go and have a talk to them. So they should be mindful about who they threaten. You've heard about the little fish that eats the little fish, and then the shark comes along and eats the bigger fish. Well, they might be a tasty little meal for us.
Okay. Well, you know, this kind of...
And I'm not in your public relations department. I'm sorry, ma'am. I'm not in your public relations department. I don't ever talk softly or gently or say the right sort of things. I mean, I'm accepting the call because of a mutual friend.
Certainly. Well, we want to thank you for that. I think that the callers I think that the listeners, whoever is out there who is monitoring this radio show, will be well aware that we've kind of brought in the big guns, so to speak, on our side. There are some people out there, wouldn't you say, caller, who consider David Wilcock to be family. Wouldn't you put it that way?
Well, let me say this, as far as I'm advised. If anyone bothers this lad or a few of the others that are around trying to tell the messages that they're telling, we'll be heartily pissed off. And it won't be one or two that'll have a headache. I can assure you countries will have headaches. And the people out there who are listening will know what I'm talking about. We don't deal in ones and twos.
Okay.
We deal in whole societies.
Okay.
Well, I don't want to encourage too much of this kind of talk, but I do want to.
Ma'am, I'm sorry. You're talking about the things at the sharp end of the business. There's none of this funny, waffy, soffy stuff that you guys all go on about. We're very serious. Nobody is to be interfered with unless they do their own things, as long as they don't break the rules, which are simple. Tell the truth and don't compromise any of the other little people's privacy. Simple as that. Not too hard to follow, eh?
So, David, you should rest assured where you are. And I just want to say I am in your neighborhood. I'm basically here if you need me in any way, shape, or form, as you know. And I can be there very, very shortly if necessary. And you are also welcome in my home at any time.
Yeah.
And your loved ones are welcome in my home.
Thank you.
And David, Midler, I'm sorry to interrupt, ma'am, but I'll be up having some snow skiing and meeting some of those lovely friends of mine in Asia. We're going to have a lovely get-together in about a week. So I'll be talking about you to make sure I know you're all right. And the leaders of these countries will also be real interested to know that you're all right and you're freely publishing whatever you want, so long as it's the truth. We'll be very upset if we don't see all your publications. I want you to send everything out. Everything you can think of, my boy. Put it all out there. A lot.
Okay. Honestly, Kerry, I was going to flee. I was going to get in my car.
Go and have a lovely dinner. I'll bet you you're one of these fellas that likes dining in around Los Angeles, somewhere around the beach. Go and do that.
Okay.
You go and do that. And if you've got any doubts, put 20 or 30 little drives, those little thumb drives. Put 20 to the friends you trust, to put another 20 around the world to people you don't even know. And give them to someone to dish out to everyone. And that's where you'll fuck them all.
Good. Excellent suggestion.
That's right. Well, get them all. Because we don't need any of that stuff.
You didn't hear this, but I already have given instructions to all Wilcock file holders, including the fact that you will be getting an update very shortly with new information. Do not release the information unless you are authorized to, which will be the code phrases that I gave you that will appear in my article.
You did that for all of them. Understand that we don't need any of that. We don't need to investigate. We have ways and means of knowing what's in everyone's information, everyone's computer. We don't need a thing. We do it in a different way. We need no physical material requirements at all. No machinery,
well,
as you understand it.
Yeah, this was my form of backup, so.
You do that because the people that are bothering you, if in fact these are even real people and not nonsense holders, they're nothing. They don't exist. They're not worth a piece of used tissue paper.
This phone call I got was serious as a heart attack, but I can tell that you are too. And
David, we're the sort of folk that don't follow you after the heart attack when you've died, son. We'll be there on the other side to bother you again.
Yeah.
Okay. So be assured, we can bother them just as effectively after their death of their body. And don't talk about torture in this life. Talk about torture in lives that go for thousands of generations.
Well, I appreciate that.
You understand what I'm saying? You understand the depths of what we're talking about?
I do.
And this phone call's coming from so far beyond the never ever, you could never appreciate it.
Okay, well, caller, thank you so much. What I would like to do is, if you don't mind, steer it back around to sort of the nuts and bolts of what the information is about and how you can contribute here. David, as far as the fact that the gold is here, it's being taken off world. It's very plentiful here on Earth. It's very attractive to many of the visitors from off world, as we know.
Yeah.
And can you address why the focus on the gold at this time with this particular group? Do you know why they're so fixated?
You're talking about this idea of gold being taken off planet?
No, I'm asking the anonymous caller if he knows why this particular group that's threatening you is so fixated on strangle.
Kerry, I mean, I can tell you why, and then he can weigh in here. But
all right.
What if, I don't want to say that. Let's just say that the scope of change, I did deliberately put myself at the tip of the spear. What's going to be happening as a result of this lawsuit getting public and why it's so important that people spread the word is that there are some people who have been doing a great deal of harm. There's a lot more people of whom Anonymous represents that group, in which, although he's talking in a way that probably is scaring the living crap out of most of the listeners, there's a greater number of people who do not wish to do harm and who are very pissed off about the fact that this very small number of people is making everybody in government, everybody who works for the military, everybody in a corporation, everybody who's in a finance company, making them look terrible. There's a small number of people who are causing the trouble. This lawsuit is intended to stop them from being able to do what they're doing. That's why I was willing to put my ass on the line by getting it out there, because what happens after we get rid of these folks, and I'm not saying kill them, I'm just saying give them a fair trial, and I don't even think they should receive the death penalty, you know? And some of them who are key involved people can plead for amnesty. But that's what we're looking at here. We're looking at a geopolitical change of massive proportions, which will unleash an incredible wave of prosperity for the planet. When this economic system is changed, the average person's prosperity will dramatically increase, and this is what we need to do. We need to do this in order to get disclosure. We need to do this in order to reconnect with our galactic family, and we need to do this to inherit the golden age that has been promised to us in so many different ancient prophecies.
Okay, thank you, David. Caller Anonymous, can you address what David has just said? Because I think you have a different point of view on that. Are you willing to say anything along those lines?
Oh, not too much there. He's got some lovely ideals, and we all hope it works out that way. It's hard. When you make an omelette, sometimes you've got to break a few eggs. But he's right about one thing. It doesn't matter what country you're in, where you're coming from. 99% of all the people in public office, all the people, all the folk that work in the civil service are genuine, caring bots. They really are lovely people. And we care for those folks. We want to see all the families happy. But it doesn't take too many rotten eggs or rotten apples to spoil a barrel or a dozen or two dozen eggs. There's always one that smells and causes the rot to set in. It's a problem.
Okay. Caller, are you willing to address the situation with the bankers that's going on in Switzerland at all? Are you interested in talking about what's going on with the money around the world and tracing it? We're going to have to come right back after this break. Thank you so much for listening. This is Kerry Cassidy, Project Camelot. Camelot Whistleblower Radio, and we are live with a very interesting situation that is a developing situation as I speak. David Wilcock has received several death threats this evening, and we were going on the air anyway, so the serendipity of the moment allowed us to to go public with the situation. And David is with us. David Wilcock is with us. We also have a caller from a secret location around the globe who has graciously come on the air here to represent a certain group. And Anonymous, are you still with us?
Hi.
Hi, Anonymous. And I appreciate you. Your Irish accent is at sometimes a bit hard to understand. So at times I will be repeating what you say. Just hope you aren't offended by that. I want people to be sure to understand you.
This is fine.
So Anonymous, can you address possibly any of the situation with regard to what's going on around the world? Is there some cautionary note or anything that you want to give people? It's very rare that you come on the air under these circumstances or that anyone from your group comes on the air. Is there any kind of message that you would like to give people about these trying times in which we are in?
There's nothing I can say specifically. Well, as I can say, there are many challenges ahead. It won't be easy. But if you keep yourself positive, and keep by your family, mind your family. Your family is everything. That is the link for we will survive. In 20 years' time, we'll be in a different world, different place, different feelings and different values. It'll be so different, it will be hard to comprehend. Many of these villains, they'll be gone, vanquished once and for all. But it takes many generations to get to this point, let alone get rid of the villains forever. It takes the world this time.
Okay, and there are many white hats among you, including yourself, who are out there fighting the good fight and going behind the scenes, going into the darkness, as I call it. In order to deal with the situation here, but they are fighting on our behalf. Isn't that true?
Yes. It is very true.
Thank you, and we do appreciate it. David, can we go back a few steps here, if you don't mind,
sure.
And describe the situation again for the people that are tuning in? With regard to Benjamin Fulford and how you feel that the arrest, I assume it was an arrest or the CIA occupation, takeover of his house or whatever, house arrest they're calling it, how that basically seemed to interweave with what's going on with you.
Well, the title of my article that caused all this mess is The Trillion-Dollar Lawsuit That Could End Financial Tyranny. I'm only reporting on something that other people are doing. The information that I reported is already public domain. The information I reported on is a lawsuit that is for $1 trillion. It is being filed on behalf of a secretive Asian group called the Dragon Family, who are the holders of vast sums of gold. I guess Anonymous would say nowhere near as vast as the gold that's actually there, but in conventional terms, we're looking at much more gold than is officially documented in the treasuries of the world or in any public forum. The Dragon Family basically owns the historical rights to this gold. It was confiscated in the 20s and 30s as part of the foundation of the current financial system under Bretton Woods in 1944. The confiscation of that gold it is all documented. It's all part of the system. It's part of a secret financial system that underwrites the currencies of the world so that most people think that they're printing bubble money, but they're actually not. It does have collateral. It's just that these Asians now want to regain that collateral because they don't like the way it's being used. And that's the actual situation that this lawsuit is trying to do. It's basically trying to change the geopolitical order, change the financial system, change the way it's run, so that there will be much more prosperity freed up for the average person, because there's a small group of people who have access to the printing press. They're printing money out of control. They have driven the whole world into a global financial meltdown. None of this needs to happen. It's all phony. It's all based on numbers and computers that have no real value. And what's trying to be done now is to reboot the global financial system. And in the aftermath of this reboot, we're going to discover that these vast national deficits were all illusions. It's all illegally gotten, and it doesn't even exist. So it's kind of like the Orwellian idea, war is peace, freedom is slavery, ignorance is strength. When the media is telling you it's global economic collapse, it's actually the best thing that's ever happened to us. This lawsuit is the tip of the spear that's doing this, and that's why apparently some people who will be affected by this, because they're going to lose their printing press. They're very upset. They issue threats to me, and now what's happening is that people who we know and trust are actually stepping out of anonymity. They're on the air, and they're saying that if these people try to harm me, that they will be harmed, and it's going to cause a lot of trouble. So I don't want to see anybody get harmed. I was actually going to be getting in my car and fleeing my house after I finished writing this article, but now I'm going to hold true. I'm going to stay home. I'm going to hold the fort. And I do not believe I will be harmed, but I have to take these threats very seriously. And that's why I'm out there making this radio show, alerting people to what's going on for my own protection and for the good of humanity.
Absolutely. And for the safety of the people around you as well.
Yes.
Anonymous, you've heard what David has to say in regard to this situation. Can you address some of the statements he just made with regard to this lawsuit and how it may affect people? Is this indeed legitimate in your estimation?
Hey, I want to follow you, David. You can drive wherever you want. I'll find you. I can sit down from a satellite and watch you from anywhere. That's not the solution, boy.
Right.
The things you're talking about, a lot of things will be discussed about the Asian situation next year. But there are the many dragons that are interested in the Phoenixes rising. The daughters of the Phoenixes coming back again, and the folks listening will know what I'm talking about. They'll know that for 100 years or more, this has all been planned. And that the naughty boys will have to take their lickings. The accomplished number of 505 will really make the love of the world far more sensitive. And they'll know when I say that how serious I truly am. It'll go back to the agreements in 1943 of the Second World War and many others that were signed, as you mentioned, the public version of the Bretton Woods Agreement. But the dynasties and the Cheng Wings and the others, who I name drop a little here, they all know that these silly little fellows shouldn't be bothering anyone. And you can all take it from me, the folks that are hearing this know what I'm saying. I think it's enough to be worrying about now, eh? It's all done. It's all finalized. It's over.
Okay, so this situation with David at this time has been addressed. Is that what you're saying, caller?
I feel it's done. It's finished with, eh? He's a man that should be able to go on his quiet way and enjoy his business.
Okay.
And the gold of this world, the gold is this world, Mom. Don't worry about it. It'll all sort itself out. It's much more valuable to be used in industries than to be sitting around in a vault somewhere.
Yeah, that's for sure. That's for sure. Well, there are many uses for the gold, and I think that's a key statement right there, which maybe that reveals the level at which these people who've made the threats really are at, because they don't understand the true use of the metal. Is that right, caller, would you say?
There's a lot we don't tell them. I mean, you tell your dog what's going on the front street, is the morning street news or whatever. I mean, why bother him with it? Let him go and pick up the bones. Pitch the paper for you.
Oh, God. Okay. Well,
let's be serious. Like, we don't want any problems with the good folk out there. We work quietly behind the scenes. The other fools are just little fools trying to grab a few million here and there. They're not worth worrying about. Understand, The only concern is for the protection of the human society as a whole. There's no distinction between countries or race or color. The human race and the genome as a whole. Forget all your nationalities and all your culture, all your prejudice. It's all created to keep you busy, to keep you occupied.
Actually, yes, very wise words coming from a secret location in an indistinct place, very, very far away. Okay, at this point...
Ma'am, I'm sorry to interrupt you, but I might have to be going. David, five of my representatives will be landing in your country within 7 days. One of them will come and visit you. Don't worry about it. We know everything about you, where to find you, what your number is. We know what your underpants size are. One of them will ask you how you are. You must tell them the truth, exactly the truth, if anyone's bothered you. If you're stressed, someone else has harassed you, you must tell them the truth. That's all.
I will tell them exactly the truth.
And if you do that, you've honored your commitments to us. Just tell the truth.
Okay.
And then say no more about it, and then we'll take it from there.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Okay. All right. Anonymous, thank you so much. Okay, we will be in touch with you, and thank you for coming forward at this time, and thank you for the group of white hats that you represent.
Well, I do apologize if the time of day is a bit longer. The distance actually is a little bit longer than what you'd expect, so there's a bit of a time delay in the back and forth in the conversation.
Absolutely. we hear you. Okay, any parting words, Anonymous, for the listeners out there?
You tell the listeners that, all your listeners, there are some difficult times ahead for everyone. I won't lie and say that. But after those times, the rainbows will be shining for everyone. Everyone on this planet will be shining in rainbows. Because there's no way we put all this time and effort in to see this beautiful race damaged or destroyed. The human race will be on, and in a million years it'll be in glory that you can never appreciate. It'll still be around.
Okay,
goodbye to you now,
right,
and thank you very much. And God be with every one of you.
Thank you. We'll be right back. Thank you very much, Anonymous.
Thank you.
We are live with David Wilcock, Maxine Taylor, and we were just speaking with an anonymous caller who had called in from parts unknown out in the greater world to relay some messages that are very important that they be relayed to certain people that are making threats upon David's life. And we do want to thank them for coming forward. We have heard that those messages did go out. David, are you on the line?
Yeah.
Okay. What I suggest you do is turn off your video, because it looks like you've got your video hooked up there. It will help the stream here and make sure it stays stable, and so keeps you with us for the last part of the show here. We have less than 15 minutes to go. I have been told to tell you that the situation is stable, that you have nothing to worry about, and that the messages have reached, gone out to the right places, and that things are being monitored. You are going to be, some people are going to be in touch with you. So after the show, you need to call a mutual friend of ours if you get a chance, and just say hello and let them know that you're feeling fine. So, David, while we've got these last 15 minutes, is there anything else that you would like to say? We do have a chat room. I just want to let you know. And I could say that to people, if the streams have been totally maxed out. People coming online now who want to listen to the show have not been able to hear the show. We apologize for that. We are going to release this show out over the air in 1 hour's time. It will go out. American Freedom Radio is working very hard behind the scenes to make this available to everyone so that it can be distributed across the board. But we are maxed out. The streams have maxed themselves out during the show, and we do apologize. So, David, do you want to give a sort of a summation of what has come down, what has gone down here, and maybe if there's anything that you need to tell people about what you're going to write in part two
that needs to be reiterated here, please do so at this time.
Well, I just want to thank everybody for caring about me enough to send in all these letters that I've received in the... I didn't know if this would ever happen. I think maybe I've lived my life with so much trust in the safety that I have. I never expected I would actually get a death threat like this. Look, I know that there's people who probably are going to think this whole thing is some elaborate game that we're playing or that it's fake. I don't know what to say. I'm not comfortable posting any comments on my website of people being sarcastic or acting like this is a joke or that I made it up. I only heard about this, I don't know, like barely an hour before this radio show started, so I haven't even really had time to think about all this. I just, in the unlikely event that something does happen to me, I just want to tell you listening that I love you, and I have always done my best to try to bring you information that will help you to be a more loving person. And I love this planet, and I love the people, and I want to see the world improve. I really feel that we have all suffered, and there's been a lot of fear, and I have worked very hard to create hope and to create faith and to help us all create the future that we deserve to have. And I didn't expect I'd be interfered with like this. I don't believe in fear, and I've always said that I would rather die once at the hands of an assassin than die every day in fear of assassination. I will do my best to pull myself together to not take this.
David, let me say that I have gotten word that the people who did threaten you will have gotten the message very, very loud and very, very clear. From the people that delivered the message on our show with you today through Anonymous. And there were some key phrases there that made it unmistakable to those who are in the know, so to speak. And that you are watched over and that you are safe. So I want you to hang in there. I just want people to understand that David Wilcock is an extremely courageous individual, and that these people that we're dealing with every day have a tremendous amount of courage, and courage comes from the heart, okay? And this is what you're hearing. You're hearing an emotional reaction from a person who has a very active heart chakra. And so this is not a sign of weakness. On the contrary, it's a sign of strength. If you have a tremendous heart, you feel it very deeply, and you feel deeply on both sides of the spectrum across the board. So I want people to understand that's what's happening here. This is live radio, and this is actually the kind of things that we live with every day. Project Camelot and our witnesses are deeply involved to this day with what we do, with what goes out over a Project Camelot and over actually is in David Wilcock's books, and David has been a very, very close witness and involved with Project Camelot, and so I want people to understand that we stand together, that we are a group, and that the people that they have seen on videos are actually in many cases part of a family of souls
And so I just wanted to say that we don't have very much time. David, if there's anything in terms of data that you need to say in the next, you've got like 4 minutes to get it out there. So aside from this situation, in terms of data, is there anything that you need to say right here and right now that people should know about?
Yes. Many of these underground bases were completely wiped out. It began on the day my book came out with one in Virginia and one in Colorado. There have been many more that have happened since then. A lot of it happened at the end of the month of September. The two drones that were taken over, one in Iran and now another one yesterday in the Seychelles, that is an ongoing part of this extraterrestrial initiative. The extraterrestrials apparently took over this drone. That drone was never supposed to be found. The Iranians now have it intact. That was given to them by extraterrestrials. The implications of that are very vast, and this is another article I needed to write, and so I will say it right now. That drone has the most advanced guidance systems of any reverse engineered technology on Earth. It was completely hacked and overtaken by extraterrestrials. The people on the inside know this. They've been having meetings about this at the highest levels. What it means is they have no defense, so they need to stand down. There is nothing you can use to attack the people. You cannot fake an alien invasion. You cannot do anything. You're completely exposed. And by coming after me, you're getting yourselves in even more hot water. You've heard this on the show. So I do not wish to be harmed. Let me do what I'm going to do. I will not out anyone's name. I will not do anything that will hurt any one person. All I'm trying to do is talk about this story. But the drone downing is a very significant element of this story. The people who are doing this are not trying to invade the planet. They're not trying to destroy the planet. They did this because they don't want you bombing Iran. They don't want you creating World War III in the Middle East. They do not want you to create an international incident. You will need to accept this change. You will need to accept stepping down from power. You will need to accept the change of the economic system. You have hated the public. You have not wanted people to have the money that they need to live a happy life. You have to change. It is being forced upon you from all sides. I know it's scary. I know that you want to attack me and threaten my life because you are scared. And this is something that everybody gets to win. So we will give you amnesty, but you have to cooperate. Thank you all for listening. I really appreciate being here.
Thank you very much. This is Project Camelot. Thank you. We will have the show available in 1 hour from American Freedom Radio to listen. And please distribute it worldwide. It is vitally important that it get out there. Thank you.